P40, prevalence of geriatric depression and associated factors in institutionalized elders, a descriptive study in Gaul district. The authors are Abesekara, NWBY, and Dizoisa, GED. The paper will be read by Abesekara, NWBY.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Buddhini Abesekara, an undergraduate nursing student from University of Rona, and I am going to present my findings of the study, Prevalence of Geriatric Depression and Associated Factors in Institutionalized Elders, a Descriptive Study in the Gaul District. When we talk about population aging, it is a significant social problem of the 21st century in the world. And Sri Lanka is considered as one of the South Asian countries which has a higher proportion of elderly population and a higher rate of population aging. Earlier, the Sri Lankan institution of family was enough to take care of their own elders, but due to gradual changes of family structure, compelled many elders to appeal for elderly care facilities at present. Institutionalized elders have to face so many problems, and it includes financial, physical and psychological problems. From those, geriatric depression, catastrophizing pain and sleep disorders are the most common and neglected problems of all that can negatively impact the lives of the affected elderly and reduce the quality of their lives. So, the aims of this study were to assess the prevalence of geriatric depression, catastrophizing pain, sleep disorders and their correlations in institutionalized elders in the Gaul district. I have conducted a descriptive cross-sectional study in 20 elderly homes in Gaul district from August to November 2019. 310 elders whose age 60 years or more and who were living more than 1 year in those elderly homes were enrolled to this study. We have used an interviewer-administered questionnaire to collect data and validated single versions of geriatric depression scale and pain catastrophizing scale were used to assess geriatric depression and catastrophizing pain. The Petersburg Sleep Quality Index was used to assess sleep disorders and the sleep quality. We have obtained ethical clearance from the Ethical Review Committee of Faculty of Allied Health Sciences, University of Rona, and we have used SPSS 25 version to analyze the data, and the level of significance, p-value, was considered as less than 0.05. Let's move to the results and discussion. According to the socio-demographic data in this study sample, majority of elders were females and were unmarried. Most of the study subjects spent 5 or less than 5 years in elderly homes at the time of the study. As you can see, about 76% of the study sample had geriatric depression, and when we talk about the severity levels of geriatric depression, about 44% of them had moderate to severe depression conditions. As you can see, about 92% of elders had catastrophizing pain according to the pain catastrophizing scale, and about 31% of them had moderate to severe conditions. Sleep disorders were identified in 55.5% of elders, and according to the Petersburg Sleep Quality Index, about 86% of them had poor quality sleep. I have analyzed the correlations between geriatric depression, catastrophizing pain and sleep disorders. The result shows that there were strong positive statistically significant correlations between geriatric depression and catastrophizing pain and catastrophizing pain and sleep disorders. However, the positive correlation between geriatric depression and sleep disorders was not statistically significant. So the findings of this study concludes that the majority of elders in this study sample were suffering from geriatric depression and catastrophizing pain, and about 1/3 of them had moderate to severe conditions. Sleep disorders were experienced by majority of the study sample, and most of them had poor quality of sleep. So the findings of this study highlights the importance of screening institutionalized elders in Sri Lanka to identify and address those psychological problems regularly. Furthermore, the findings highlight the importance of developing government-based programs to improve psychological health and to enhance quality of life of this institutional elderly population in Sri Lanka in the near future to address the emerging challenges of population aging. These are some of my references, and I I would like to acknowledge all the elders who took part in this study and all the administrative staff in elderly homes and the Commissioner of the Social Service Department, GAL, for giving the opportunity to conduct this study. Thank you all for listening.
Thank you very much. The paper is now open for discussion.
Significant now morbidity here. Now, are these patients being seen, I mean, these elders being seen by anybody in the nursing or these elders homes, or they are just stuck there? Are they going to clinics or someone is visiting to see them?
Some of them are going to clinics, but not getting the treatments for psychological matters. Their regular clinics for their comorbidities like hypertension and so on. They are not treated for any kind of psychological problems. I have excluded those elders who had diagnosed with severe psychological problems.
So have they expressed about these problems to the medical people who were seeing them? Or?
Yes, sir. But most of the time they have been ignored because they concern them as those problems are coming with the old age, and they are always complaining about pain and sleep disorders, so they are willing to neglect those problems as the usual problems of them.
Do you think there's a significant difference between the institutionalized elders and the elders who are being cared at home?
Yes, madam.
So
I have observed those elders who are living in those institutions.
Do you have any comparative studies?
No, sir. No, madam. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of Free Paper Session 7. I would like to thank the 7 presenters for their very interesting presentations, and let us show our appreciation in the customary manner, please. My thanks also go out to our judges for this session. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Have a pleasant day.